Radio 1's Live Lounge.
Radio 1.
It is Radio 1, and it's time now to get some Live Lounge action. So we go over to Maida Vale, where we'll say welcome to, I think they're all there, Benny, Alex, and Brian. Collectively, they are Gaslight Anthem. Morning.
Good morning.
How do we find you today?
Good.
Wonderful.
Wunderbar.
I was actually going to ask you whether you speak many European languages. So, German, obviously, you're fluent.
We fumble with a few of them.
Yeah, we mess around.
I wouldn't say fluent, but...
dabble.
Dabble, yeah, is a word.
Okay, how else can you impress me? What other languages can you speak?
We speak, hola. American slang real well.
Speak jive. We can talk jive. Yeah.
Hola, muchacho.
Swedish?
Oh, yeah, fluent Swedish. Yeah, we learned that in all the schools.
Don't you know Latin?
It's a dead language, isn't it? It's not a spoken language, so...
Well... Alex is keeping it alive.
It depends on what corner you end up on.
Or Esperanto, we do that too.
God, does anybody do that anymore? Brian, how are your teeth today? Can you just tell people who don't know the story of what happened to your teeth? Because you had a horror time. It's kind of a documented in Hugh magazine.
Yeah, we're still in the middle of that, actually.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I'm getting them kind of redone.
Did you get, like, massive infection?
That was, like, actually dental work that had gone bad. And it kind of happens sometimes. I have, like... weird roots. You're supposed to have two, and I have four and three and mutant teeth. They're weird. But they, I don't know. It's just
good album title.
Yeah, that's not really
the
good.
Mutant teeth.
It got crazy. And you know, I've kind of been through the ringer now, and I'm kind of in the middle of it. So.
Oh, but surely, I get bad ulcers. I've been talking about this on there a lot recently. And it really gets you down, like the middle of the night when your mouth is just killing you. It can be quite miserable. That must have happened for you.
Yeah, I don't like it so much. But, and I don't even drink or anything to take it away. So it's just like, I just lay there with it.
Moaning.
I don't moan so much. I kind of just bitterly grind my teeth like a proper old man.
And then do the more damage as well. But did you have to cancel any gigs?
Nope. We pulled the tooth out around 8:30 and played a show at 11:30.
Oh my gosh. I guess the adrenaline from playing on stage is kind of the best thing that you can possibly get.
No, I needed a good story. I was running low on good stories, so I needed something to talk about.
You are doing, I've got pretty much any festival that's going around the world, I think, throughout this entire summer. You're doing loads of European ones, doing Fuji as well.
Yeah.
You'll be playing the John Peel stage at Glastonbury. Have you heard about Glastonbury? Have you ever been to Glastonbury before?
Yeah, I watched that Joe Strummer documentary and about how he was hanging out and camping there, and I'm kind of interested to see if we can catch the same vibe over there.
So do that.
Yeah, I think that might be one of those things where we kind of just sit out there and see what happens. And I love the fact that he didn't separate himself from all the people that were there. It's so legendary, you know? Like, even in America, it's a huge deal over there. You're just like, Glastonbury, whoa.
Aww.
I can make a really good campfire.
Can
really?
You? Right, yeah. So we're coming. Which day are you playing now? I'm going to find out, and I'm going to be there around your campfire.
You got to, well, you show up, and we'll make you some marshmallows.
Excellent. We can toast marshmallows together.
Yeah, why not?
All right, you're going to do the single for us now. Are you ready to do this?
Yeah, we're ready to do this.
On Radio 1 now, in the Live Lounge for us, this is the Gaslight Anthem.
Something quiet.
Anthem on Radio 1 in the Live Lounge for us, and that was a 59 sound. You are going to be supporting Bruce Springsteen when he does the Hyde Park gigs.
Yeah, local boys overseas.
Yeah. Was he something of a hero to you, or somewhat, some kind of a big influence, or just somebody who you kind of quite liked?
He's kind of like a more of like a like an icon, I think, that like musically, a lot of people ask us, you know, what the story is with that. And I think that Bruce is somebody you kind of like locally, you know, want to grow up to be like your dad, but cooler, yeah. You know?
So have you had contact with Bruce Springsteen?
Yeah.
So he's a big supporter of yours?
He's a nice guy, yeah. He's a good guy.
Is he?
He's
I want to
really
know more
nice.
About him. What's he like as a guy?
I don't know what shoe size he wears, but we're not that close.
I think he's about a six. I don't think he's got big feet.
Maybe a 9.5.
But
he's real regular. Like, you would think that it's almost like somebody forgot to tell him he was famous.
Oh.
Which is cool, you know?
Yeah, that's very good. Okay, right. We'll get more from you. I'll let you just get yourselves ready, and we'll come back for more from the Gaslight Anthem after this.
All right.
Thank you.
Radio 1's Live Lounge.
Radio 1. Radio 1, it's the Live Lounge, and over at Maida Vale, we're enjoying the music of the Gaslight Anthem. Also their company as well, getting to know them a little bit better. If you just tuned in, you missed the 59 sound, but you can listen to that again at your leisure whenever you want to, courtesy of the BBC iPlayer. You're enjoying yourselves there, yeah? At our BBC Maida Vale studios?
Yeah, it's a good time here. It's kind of a privilege to be here, I think, for all of us.
Oh, we're so chuffed to have you on the show. We've had Frank Turner did the show for us in the past, and I know you've been out on tour with him. He's a good man.
I love Frank.
He did us his cover, a bit of Take That and Rule the World, which was very good, cheesy, which we like.
Well, what are you going to do, you know?
Yeah, and King Blues as well. Are you friends of King Blues?
Yeah, we went on a small tour with them. We know those guys.
Yeah, and they did Dizzy Rascal and Bonkers, which is big hit over here in the UK at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
So that was a lot of fun as well. If I could just ask some more trivial questions of you, if that's all right.
That's my bag.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, your strength. Oh, right, I'm going to go right for it. If you could date one celebrity, who would that celebrity be?
Oh, Chelsea Handler. Easy.
Who's that?
Oh, she's a filthy American comic. It's something wrong with her. But she's, I don't know. I just got this thing for her. She's sassy.
Okay, and she's a comic.
Sassy. Yeah,
so you like him to make you laugh and then to have the curves as well.
All right.
Who's your favorite cartoon character?
Oh, cartoon character. Mm-hmm. I think Calvin and Hobbes. I like that.
Yeah.
That's like a good one.
Okay. Karaoke song. If you've ever been and done a bit of karaoke, what's the song that you love to do?
Totally Eclipse of the Heart.
Yay, Bonnie Tyler rocks it. Good. Do you have any famous people in your phone book?
In my phone book?
Well, no, your phone.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess,
well, who?
Yeah.
Tell me why.
I don't want to tell them because then kids will beat me up for the numbers to try to steal my phone.
Do you have the boss's phone number?
No, come on.
Okay.
I don't want to call him.
Yeah, what would you say to him?
Nothing. That's exactly it. I would just, what am I going to talk to him about?
Just mumble.
Yeah,
What is on your rider, apart from toothbrushes?
Me, personally, just coffee. I have the lowest sense of that kind of, I forget that there's, I'm supposed to ask for stuff. I don't know what's wrong. Like, I think I should learn to ask for more things.
Be more demanding.
Yeah, you know, but my dad would just not be happy with that.
Oh, and it's all about keeping the parents happy.
Yeah, what do you got? Two legs? Go get yourself. What do you need? Somebody got it for you. That's my dad. So I got two legs. I'm going to go.
Okay. Do you like, are you into movies? Do you like films at all?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you like musicals?
No.
Oh, you see, I've got, Paint
Come
Your Wagon. No. Do you know Paint Your Wagon?
No.
Oh, you're sounding to me like Lee Marvin in Paint Your Wagon. I'm casting you now in a movie. It's like a real rock and roll cowboy film.
Rock and roll.
Yeah. I'm going to recommend that you go and watch Paint Your Wagon and you will love it.
I'd rather Paul Newman. Next time we chat, try Paul.
Okay, you reminded me of Paul Newman.
No, thank you very much. Wow, that's a really nice thing to say. Thank you. I've always wanted someone to say
that. That's right. No, flattery is my thing.
All right. And receiving flattery is mine. We're a team.
Are you ready to do your cover for us? And tell us not what it is, but why you've chosen this.
Okay. I've chosen this because I have a younger sister, and I imagine that it reminds me of her, because she's staunch with the boys. Very, 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 she's very good at telling boys, you know, go take a hike. And I love that about her. When she was a little kid, she was so good at that. And she would snap their hearts right in two.
Oh!
You know, and it's not cool when it's happening to you, but when it's your little sister, you're proud of her.
Oh, she's a feisty female.
Oh,
okay.
She's wonderful.
Okay, what's her name?
Her name is Danielle.
Danielle.
Yeah.
Okay, go for it then. Gaslight Anthem on Radio 1.
All right. Too much talent, I see you through those bloodshot eyes. There's a cure, you found it, slow motion sparks, you've caught that chill. Now don't deny it, girls will be girls, oh yes they will. And they don't wanna define it, just give up the game, get into me. Looking for thrills and get cold feet. And oh no, I do not look up, I go slow. So if you want me, I don't come cheap. Keep your hand in my hand and your heart on your sleeve. And oh no, I do not look up, I fall deep. Cause the more that you try, harder I'll fight to say goodnight. I can't cook, but I can clean up the mess she left, and lay your head down and feel the beat as I kiss your forehead. This may not last, but this is now. Baby, love the one you're with. Wanna chase, but you're chasing your tail. A quick fix won't ever get you well, but oh no, I do not hook I'll go slow. Baby, if you want me, I don't come cheap. Keep your hand in my hand and your heart on your sleeve. Oh no, I do not hook I fall deep, and the more that you try, the harder I'll fight to say. Cause I feel the distance between could be over with the snap of your finger. Oh no, I do not look I go slow. And if you want me, I don't come cheap. Keep your hand in my hand and your heart on your sleeve. And oh no, I do not look I fall deep, and the more that you try, the harder I fight to say, oh no, I do not hook up, I go slow. Baby, if you want me, I don't come cheap. Keep your hand in my hand and your heart on your sleeve. And oh no, I do not hook up, I fall deep, and the more that you try, say yes, more that you try, the harder I fight. Say goodnight, oh sweetheart. Put the bottle down, cause you don't wanna miss out.
Okay, let me be the first to say it. I've got goosebumps. I know the listeners will be saying that right away. I absolutely love that. Brian, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you.
God, that was Kelly Clarkson's I Do Not Hook Up, as done by the Gaslight Anthem, or Brian from Gaslight Anthem. The words just kind of leapt out. I'd never really listened to them, and they didn't kind of have the same effect when I heard Kelly Clarkson do it, but that was great.
Thank you.
She's really feisty as well, Kelly Clarkson. Love her.
I love it. It's great, you know? She's good.
Yeah, no, she came in the lifeline. She did the same thing as you've just done, and she was really, really good company as well. Thank you very much. Well, enjoy the festivals.
Well, thank you very much for having me.
It's an absolute pleasure. Pleasure all ours. And I'll see you at the campfire at Glastonbury, and I'll bring the marshmallows.
You're on.
We'll do some toasting.
We're doing it.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
All right, bye-bye.